and Malta Geek, and Ochi's running well, and so is Perrick. And Ochi and Perrick, these two at the moment, right on the outside, Ingemiller going well, and here comes Ochi into the straight, Perrick giving chase, and Dweezy on the inside, and Ochi's being run down by Perrick at the moment, and Ochi hanging on, and Perrick's going to take the championship, Ochi in second, Onyali, I think, got the bronze.
The worst, toughest 200 I've ever run in my entire life. I ran with some of the greatest athletes in the world. I don't think that lineup will ever come anything will ever come close to that lineup.
Definitely.
I went into that 200 meters more relaxed than I was in the 100. In the 100, I wanted it so bad. I was above my limit. I was out of my zone. I was out of focus. It was so intense for me, but I was running like a chicken without a head at the end of the day. And that was exactly what happened. Because about 60 or 70 meters, I was blank. I didn't even know what I was doing. I didn't know how I got to the tape. I got to the tape with 11.17, coming in seventh. About 20 meters to the end of the 100 meters, I was in tears. I couldn't believe I wasn't getting a medal. That's how bad I wanted it. So going into after the junk off my head, going into the 200, I just told myself, just relax and have fun. Don't put too much tension on yourself. And 200 being a more natural race for me, it was a whole lot easier. But that final was not easy. I came this close to getting fourth again. And when I saw Inga on the right-hand side trying to sneak me, sneak in on me, I was like, I said to myself, hell no, I'm losing this bronze again.
You were very happy, sure.
Oh, yes.